The claw of Geryon, cut from the creature of the same name, drives out all inspiration from anyone who enters into contact with it. It is thus an object that humans consider to be cursed, and they do not keep it for long. Finding it will not be easy. My informers on Earth heard talk of a poet lacking inspiration who had received a visit from the Sanctuary Lumen. My disciples will begin there. My disciples go to the home of a poet suffering from creative impotence. Apparently, this insignificant individual had received a visit from the Sanctua Lumen, an occurrence that immediately aroused our interest. Hoping to find here the point of departure in their quest for the Claw of Geryon, they enter the rundown hut and find a young man ferociously tearing up pages covered in crossings out. He unquestionably bears the mark of Geryon. He tells us how men of the Sanctua Lumen suddenly burst in, took the claw, and immediately left for the town of Pere. That is where my disciples will go. My influence is growing. This village is much too calm. Let us sow chaos in their midst.
I heard you. You called me 3 times. Are we playing?
I'm parched.
It seems I got carried away.
Who should I kill?
My power is invincible. Take everything you can. Smell that deathly silence. I feel right at home. Sacrifice to dominate. Choose quickly. Evil will not spread by itself.
Should I kill?
I'm listening, Master.
What game are we playing?
It's not all I get, Geryon. The most severe punishments await you. It's high time I interfered. The devil is in the details. The dice were loaded from the start. The devil is in the details. The dice were loaded from the start. It's almost boring. I am pleased with these offerings. Take them! I hear the murmurs of the trees. They're fed up with humans. Let us answer their prayers. Show them the power of evil.
I'm parched.
Should I kill?
Leave me alone!
Something done right, do it yourself. My power is absolute.
I'm parched.
Who should I kill?
are we playing?
How dare you attack me, mortal?
Listening, Master.
Farewell, mortal.
You want something done right? Do it yourself. Reality is but a toy to me. The only limit to my power is my imagination.
You don't hold anything back. I'll do likewise. Who should I kill?
I'm parched. I feed in the darkness.
Evil is never vanquished. It's nothing more than a slight setback. Interesting. Geryon. My disciples go to the home of a poet suffering from The people fear me once again. That is how it should be. Finally, fresh sand. None must escape.
I'm listening, Master.
Your neck is so appetizing.
What game are we playing? Do you know what dirt tastes like? That'll be right.
Here I am, ready again.
Let me return the kindness.
I'm parched.
What game are we playing?
Should I kill?
What game are we playing? Dirt tastes like.
I shall reforge the world in my image. The only limit to my power is my imagination.
Darkness makes me stronger.
Who should I kill?
I'm parched.
Couldn't have ended any other way. I am pleased with these offerings. Take them. So many innocent souls, and so little time to corrupt them all.
At your service, Master.
Something done right, do it yourself. The only limit to my power is my imagination.
Perfect.
With that, the humans will finally submit to my yoke.
Knowledge is power.
The curse will pay for that.
At your service, Master. Perfect.
Scream as loud as you can, condemned souls. I'm the only one who can hear you.
Knowledge is power.
I accept my punishment.
Knowledge is power.
I hate fields. I'd love to see them burn. This sacrifice will make one of you more powerful. But who will I choose? Choose quickly. Evil will not spread by itself. Irresistible.
Should I kill?
What game are we playing?
I'm parched.
I'm listening, Master.
It seems I got carried away. I'm listening, Master. I feed in the darkness.
Mortal that bows down before my power is a good mortal. These relics are potent enough to contain my power. Many humans lie dead among the roots of these trees. I quite like this place.
At your service, Master.
Perfect.
The nightmare is only beginning.
Knowledge is power. At your service, Master. Perfect.
Really? It's for me.
Knowledge is power.
Soon the humans will all bow down before me.
Knowledge is power.
My disciples enter Pere. They approach the main square, from where they can hear loud voices. Residents are shouting a name, hope etched on their faces. Caleb, Caleb. The Saitua Lumen is there, and among them a man holding the claw of Geryon in his bare hand. He raises the claw, and the townsfolk go silent. With a sweeping movement, he brings the artifact down upon his arm. No blood flows from the deep gash. A respectful murmur is heard. The wound closes. He speaks. Serve the Saitua Lumen, and you will be rewarded. I immediately understand the true nature of this Caleb. He is an imitation human. I revealed to my disciples the existence of a puppeteer specialized in automaton who once made a pact with me. They will find him in the town of Capellion. Fear my rage. Think that such a powerful relic was hidden in this rat hole. This forest isn't so terrifying. Not yet.
Really? It's for me!
When I give, I get. Take everything you can. Their time is counted. You shall not leave until all the mortals in this region have bowed down before me. Ah, a conductor of souls. All those innocent souls I harvested will finally be of use. The Kurs will pay for that. What a charming valley. My disciples will have... My influence is growing.
not my head, but it'll do.
I didn't expect that. At your service, Master. Perfect.
Souls rotten with vice.
Knowledge is power.
There's nothing like the vile waters of the Styx to invigorate me. Terribly sorry, but it seems your time has come. I'm parched. Let me return the kindness.
What game are we playing?
Mine.
ready again.
What dirt tastes like. Oh, you're going to love it.
Playing?